University in Wellington became a hub of Samoan arts and culture recently in a significant series of gestures as part of the Treaty of Friendship celebrations with Samoa. Lisa Tauma has more.
He's been called many things in his long-term position as the Prime Minister of Samoa. Now he can add doctor to his list of honorifics.
Well, it came as a very pleasant surprise, in the sense that the university recognizes the contributions that have been made by my team.
It wasn't the only surprise on the day. Along with the honorary degree came a package of educational goodies for the National University of Samoa, including Masters and PhD scholarships to Victoria University and a scientific research fund.
For Victoria to give us scholarships to get one of our staff members to Masters and PhD, that's a great opportunity. That's a lot of money they're willing to for our staff developments.
It's all part of recognising the partnership between New Zealand and Samoa in the Treaty of Friendship, the only treaty of its kind that New Zealand's ever signed with another country, which was re-signed earlier this month by John Key in Samoa.
60% of our Pacific population are New Zealand-born Samoan. They grow up proud to be Kiwi because they have a birthright and citizenship here, but they're also Samoan.
And it's this Samoa-New Zealand fostering of family that's also seen the New Zealand government donate $5 million in school fees to Samoa and an increased immigration quota this year. New Zealand Post has also come up with these cool Samoan stamps and a special coin to commemorate the occasion. While there are gifts aplenty in 2012, New Zealand's darker history as an administrator of Samoa hasn't been forgotten and is recognised as an important part of Samoan and New Zealand history. Victoria University has put a number of archival documents from this turbulent period on display for the first time, including telegrams from the New Zealand administrators who oversaw the Talune influenza disaster in 1918. And moving on from Samoa's troubled past to its promising future, a new book has also been launched looking at the trials and tribulations that the country has faced in the years since independence.
The good thing about this sort of compilation is that it tells the whole story, or at least, you know, it tells the story from different perspectives. And that also follows the spirit of the celebration, which says this is everyone's celebration the way they see it. Because, you know, people do see things differently.
The book covers an array of topics from socio-political issues to the economy, sports and the arts.
The New Zealand Samoa history isn't really well known, including by our own people. And I think it's really important that we do know how we've come to be where we are here in New Zealand today.
To have it at the university, and to have young students like ourselves immersed in the environment of which we're here today, it helps to raise awareness on why we're actually here in 50 years later.